It is super simple to delete a record in Entity Framework. So here, what we're doing is we are looking for a student called John. So you can see John's name here. We're comparing against the name field in the backend table. We are using the first or default method here to find John. And once we found him, we store him in this variable. And then I've just got a Rapunzel write line here, which will basically print John's name and city. And this will let us confirm that it is John that we are looking at, the John that we want to delete. And once we have that, we are going to check that John has definitely been found, so it hasn't returned null, for example. And then we are going to remove John. So to remove him, you basically call the context, the student's table, and you call the remove method, pass it the student that we found. So this student over here, and that's basically what we found, which is stored in that variable. We just pass it over here and then leave the rest to Entity Framework, because it's Entity Framework's job to go and match the relevant student that it's found. So it knows its primary key and so on. So you don't need to worry about that. And then you simply, in order to commit those changes to your database, you call this method on the context class. And once that is done, then your student is deleted. So let's have a look at our database. So this is SQL Server, and we're using SQL Server Management Studio here. So here we have John. So you can see John, age, then city. His ID number is 28 in the database. So we want to get rid of John. Now, Entity Framework application, we search for John. Once we find him, we print his details, and then we simply pass him to the remove method. So what we pass within here is this variable. So if I run this code here, so you can see we found John and then we deleted the student. So if we didn't call the save changes method, your changes would not be committed to the database. In this instance, we did. So if we go back over to our database, so here we are back in our database, and if you can see, John was dead. But if I refresh this over here, okay, and now that it has been refreshed, you can see John has disappeared from our list. So it is very simple to delete a student. It's basically a two-step process. Find the student, use the first or default method, look for whatever criteria you want to match against, you know, ask the user, do they want to delete this John? If they do, run your code over here, pass John to the remove method, and then simply save changes back to the database by calling this method, and Entity Framework will take care of the rest for you.